If you are a morning person and you are able to wake up before your kids get up, if you have kids, then it's great to do that and the house is nice and quiet. And find a little space that you use as your meditation space and that you can come back to every day, and that is your spot to anchor you. And if you can, have a cushion under your bum to slightly elevate your hips as well, and that helps so that your helps to stop your legs and your knees and your hips from aching. So once you're in this pose, you can put your cross your legs, you can put your hands in your lap, and then your thumbs can gently touch. This helps with the energy flow of the body. Your arms are not squeezed next to the body, they're out just nice and relaxed. It helps the air also to move around. And your head is neither too high or too low, but just slightly tilted down. Then your jaw is relaxed. We hold a lot of tension in our jaws, so really sort of be mindful of that and really try to relax your jaw. And then put the tip of your tongue behind your top teeth, your top front teeth. This, like the thumbs, also has to do with the way that the energy flows in your body. But if you can keep your eyes open, just a little bit open, gaze down in the direction of your knees, and that helps you to stop from falling asleep. So you breathe in and out through the nose, and you try to really send the breath deep into the body, and you can even put your hands on your lower abdomen and feel your hands, your breath filling your hands. And because we so often breathe just up here with short breaths, so not really filling our body to the full capacity, it's wonderful just as a start to just think of taking 20 breaths. And every time your mind wanders to something else, you have to start back at one.